Well, if the experts at JPL are right, you have less than 2.5 years to get ready for an earthquake. They're predicting a 5.0 or stronger. CBS 2 Serene Branson is live in the newsroom to tell us why the experts are so certain. Serene.
And Paul, I spoke with the lead scientist on the NASA-led research project in Pasadena tonight. In this study published today, they make some sobering conclusions about the next big one. Although seismologists at the USGS are calling the numbers into question, they do agree that the chances are very high.
We measure how the Earth's crust stretches and strains. Okay. So it's like taking some silly putty that's pretty cold and we pull it. It stretches for a while and then it breaks.
That's how the JPL geophysicist Dr. Andrea Donnellan describes how she and seven other scientists use radar and GPS to measure our chances for a sizable earthquake. They studied the La Habra quake in March of 2014. The 5.1 caused a lot of damage.
So when the La Habra earthquake happened, it was relieving some of that stress. It actually shook the upper sediments in the LA basin and moved those a little bit more.
But those measurements indicated strain is still there.
There's enough energy stored to produce about a magnitude 6.1 to 6.3 earthquake.
That's near the La Habra epicenter. But they then went on to look at probabilities of a quake for the entire LA area, a 60-mile radius.
How many fives should we have? And that's where we came up with a 99% chance of an earthquake magnitude 5 or greater.
That's a nearly 100% chance of at least a moderate quake in the next 3 years. But seismologists at the USGS question that percentage, saying chances are slightly less. They maintain, due to their national seismic hazard maps, the accepted random chance of an M5 or greater in this area in 3 years is 85%, independent of the analysis in this paper. Either way, scientists say those probabilities are high.
We all need to be prepared. That's not new for LA.
Now, as for why the numbers are different, they use different scientific methods. NASA used radar, GPS, and probability, whereas the USGS used their fault maps and models. Pat, back to you.